It's fantastic to have you here with us at the London Film and Comic Con. Have you been enjoying yourself already this morning, meeting lots of fans?
It's always a pleasure to meet fans, because it's if you do film and television mostly, you don't encounter the fan base as directly as when you're doing theatre. And everybody's been very nice and very happy to be here in sunny Olympia.
What are the most common questions they seem to ask? What do they always want to know about?
Well, it depends on which particular movie. They very often want to know about what was it like with a certain other actor or actress. They want to know what were they like, how was that. That's a common question. And they want to know which is my favorite movie. And they like to know if I know whatever town they come from. And I'm fairly well traveled, so generally I do. I mean, I've enjoyed everything I've done. There are some films which I'm particularly pleased the way they emerged, but even films which don't necessarily fulfill your expectations can still be very worthwhile. So yes, I have many favorites, but I don't want to name them because they're all my favorites. It's a continuum. It's all a body of work, and I'm very fulfilled and proud of the body of work. I enjoyed my work on Gotham very much. The production values are incredible, and the level of writing and performances by all the actors. I felt very honored to be part of that ensemble. The fortunate thing about arachnophobia is that I don't have arachnophobia. Members of my family are always screaming when they see spiders, asking me to come and deal with them, which I always catch them in my hands and, you know, release them. I picked up tarantulas from the middle of the road in California and taken them to the safety of the shrubbery. Although my nerves were challenged in the death scene, when I had to have about 200 of these small little spiders on my face, and they were, you know, it was all real, no CGI. And I had this special mask, which they dropped them down a funnel so they could suddenly pull the mask away and be filming. But for several minutes, I had to, you know, I was very conscious, all these little legs running around my eyes and mouth. And yeah, that was a memory. Well, Room with a View was characterized for me by the sweetness and dearness of that group of actors: Denham Elliott, Simon Callow, Maggie Smith, Judy Dench, Daniel Day-Lewis, and Helena Bonham Carter, most of all. It was a really lovely time.
What are you working on at the moment? Where are we going to see you next? Hopefully many places.
Well, I'm at the moment on tour with a theatre piece based on Harold Pinter's life and work, which is touring in America. I have done it in England. I took it to the Edinburgh Festival a couple of years ago, and there are I may be in London doing that again soon. Look out for a film called The Loner, which will be out later this year or next year, in which I play a crazy but lovable gangster in LA. It's a really stylish, neon, gothic, noir film, The Loner.